Hello and welcome to Telescope Models. My name's Steve. In today's video, I thought we could talk about how and what I've been up to doing the U-Boat. That's the Revell 172 Premium Edition U-Boat. So we'll have a look on the bench. I'll move the cameras around and we'll go down to the bench and I'll go for what we've done. I've got some still photographs and a little bit of video play which I need to edit as well. So we'll have a look for that. Right, so as you can see, I've got the two halves together. We have the torpedo section in, with the doors open, and we've also started doing some of the PE on the side. I think I might need to do that bit again because it's a little bit proud, but. These pieces of PE on here, they are so tiny. It's like a break from doing PE, and I thought I'd start on the rear section, which is what we're doing here. So I'm just using the UMP sanders here just to sand down these seam lines, and they are pretty predominant as well, so if you are doing this kit you need to look out for these because they are there. And if you don't deal with them, I think it's probably best to deal with them while they're not on the model to make it easier to do. But yeah, they are quite thick ones as well. It's not like they've taken a light sand to get them off. They are. I'm having to put bit of pressure on them and it goes all the way around the part. So yeah, they definitely needs dealing with. Now I'm hoping that this is going to show up. This is part of the rudder section and I don't know if that's going to show too well. Come on, focus, please. Focus. Focus. It's because I'm too close. I don't know. Alright, you might be able to see there, but there's a seam line going across there. And it is also on this side as well, so I'm going to have to sand that off. And looking at it, it is also on one of the somewhere. It's going to be on both of the shafts. You're not going to see that at all. Focusing is terrible. Let's see if it's going to do it now. Change the focus. Boom. Nope. Really doesn't want to show it, does it? Focused it, but you might just be able to see that there's some seam line going down there. So I need to sand that down as well. So that's what I'm doing at the moment. Right, so here we are with the U-Boat. Made some good progression so far. I'll go through with what I've done, and then hopefully we've also got some pictures in here. So I started off, if you can see that, I'm not sure, but I have drilled out all the portholes, not portholes, oh, drain holes, portholes, don't have portholes on the submarine, and on both sides, and some of the back, and the underneath. But some of the plastic, it gets very hard to do because it's very thick, so it's not done all of it. We've got some on the very back as well. Then after that, I did the torpedo assembly, which is done inside, and it's all painted in there as well. And we got the more drain holes drilled out. Notice that I've still got three more to drill out just there. You just see that? Yep. So yeah, so that's still to do, which I've just noticed. Then I started on the rear section, and we've done all the rear rudder section. Now these do all move, but very loosely. It's not going to be something that's going to be moving. So although they move at the moment, I will glue them in place once I finish painting and everything. I haven't put on the props because I want to paint them separately. I want to paint them the brass colour, so they are done separately. Potentially the props can spin, but it's quite tight. This does rotate, and so does this one. But like I say, the fins and everything do turn as well. So that's done on there. Then we went to the front, and we did the front bow planes. Now these are glued inside together, so they both turn at the same time. So that's good. And that was quite a simple assembly, done very, very simply indeed. You see that we do have some gaps there, which I've just really noticed, so I might have to address those at some point. Not sure, because I've started putting the photo etch. I've all these bits of photo etch on here, and the light's going to catch it or not. You can just see the brass shining. So we've got there, here, and here, and then there's a couple more. You can see there's one, where are we? There's one here, and then there's another one there. There isn't any on the back, surprisingly, but hey. We've done that on both sides, so we've got them on there, down this back, and like I say, there's nothing on the back. Then I started, I do apologise, started on the snorkel. The snorkel does work, as in goes up and down. Doesn't breathe in here. but I think I've messed up slightly on here. I do need to move one of these parts and glue it, because when you put it down, it doesn't go down lie flat completely. You'll see there that it sits proud a little bit. So I've got to address that as well. We've also started the photo etch on the main of the deck. So this was put down first of all, the front on the deck, and then there's some little pieces of brass put on top there. You can see them. There was one supposed to go there, but it just binged off everywhere. And then we've got some more pieces done there on both sides. And then we went to the back, and we've done more. So again, the plate was put down. It's a little bit proud on the sides, so I have had to sand down this side a little bit. So we put the plate down, and then we had to bend some brass and stuff, and we put these on. These go down very easily. They are brass, solid brass pieces, so they're quite easy. Then we have going along, we have more of those there, but then in the deck itself, they might not come up, I'm not sure why. If you can see, there you go, there are tiny little pieces of brass. So there's little hatches, or hinges should I say, and then handles. They're not working hinges, so it's not too bad, but they're all in there. But they are so tiny, you can start it on there as well. And we've worked slowly started working our way back. So there's still some more to do there. These are just plates which are put on, brass plates, to represent more hatches. But yeah, so that is where we are. But these little hinges, they are so small. And thankfully, excuse me, I'm not bending anything at the moment. I have done some bending, not particularly great. But if I just show, I don't know if you're going to see that, but you can see my thumb, so you can see how tiny those bits are. They are the hinges. Ooh, go that way. They are the hinges which have been placed in. Now, luckily, what I am using, the wax pencil. I am finding that I'm having to keep that sharpened very regularly to get that fine point, just to pick it up and place it where it needs to go. Now, also what I have found is sometimes with these tiny pieces, they do just bing off. Now, another fellow modeler, said that he uses an apron and attaches to the bench, and if he goes off, it falls into the apron. Yeah, that's nice if it falls in front of you, but I've heard it ping way over there, and it's like, no. So, yeah, but luckily so far, only a couple of bits, and it is only these tiny ones. So, what I'm not looking forward to is I'm putting it off. There is a hatch that has to be built, and it's a hatch which is a working hatch. And my word, I haven't counted how many bits of brass there are, but you start off there with that piece. Let's just see if it's going to focus, probably not. And you take off the pink, obviously, as people know. Then you've got more to put on, more and more. Sorry if this is in focus, I do apologize. So, and more and more, and that's just the underside. And then you go to the top side. Now look if it's gonna focus on there. Focus. Come on, focus on me, please. No, it's not going to focus, but you can see there's a hell of a lot to do just to make that hatch be a working hatch. So, yeah, not looking forward to that one. I'm putting it off and putting it off. Might have to get Lewis to do it for me. No, he won't. So, yeah, so that's where I am with the U-boat. I am enjoying it, don't get me wrong. Oh yeah, so of course, maybe it, we've got the wooden deck down. Now, what I did with this, if I can show some other bits. Excuse me. So, this is how this was in there, like that. And it comes in three pieces. So you've got one length, second length, things around about there, and then you have another piece which does some other bits and pieces for the tower. So what I've done, I cut very closely, followed it around with a sharp knife, tamiya knife, cut it all out, laid it on so I could see exactly where it went, and then started peeled off the backing paper, backing plastic from about from the front, and just slowly pulled it back and laid it down, laid it down. Now you cut out all these sections as well, so on here it'd be these round, and you cut them out as well on them, and this should line up with these spaces. I did find that on this front one there's two places where it doesn't line up. Let me just move that out of the way. Here and here. But all is not lost, because in actual fact these pieces here, you've been told to sand them down anyway, and you're going to put more, you put a silver plate on there, and then you'll put more of these on them, so it's not such a huge, oh, it's good for me. But yeah, this putting it around here was a little tricky, so what I did, I cut it here and here so that this piece, I think it's it, the joins around here somewhere. It's so good you can't really see where the join is without really, really looking. Yeah, I think that's the join there. So literally I had one, two and three pieces, purely because when it's on the backing paper it's fine, but when you take it off, I do fuck you. Even if I go to film, I start yawning. I don't know why. So it was very flimsy enough. And the back of this plastic on the back here, the undertime when it's on the wood, is very sticky. So I didn't want to have to, if it had to stick, and then have to try and pull it back up again and rip it. So I decided to cut there and there. So it gave me one, two, and three pieces. And I'm glad I did that, because, yeah. And it looks good though. You see. So cut here, here, and you can just see there, maybe, well, I made a slight mistake, but other than that you can't see any, it went down very well, so I'm really pleased. So yes, I am pleased with it. It's going to be a long build, because this photo etch is so time consuming, putting these really tiny pieces in, but it will be worth it in the end. So thank you for watching today's video. I do hope you enjoyed it. If so, please click on the like button, and also click on the subscribe button if you haven't done so already. And if you would really like to, that would be fantastic. If you could share it around as well, that would make it even better. That's just fantastic if you could do something like that to help the channel go even further. Don't forget, we have the Saturday night crash that's held between the three of us. That would be myself on Totally Scale Models, or we've got James on Model Officer, or we have Carl on Making Models. We go every Saturday, and we're also joined by Lewis from the Model Trucker, and also Nat, who is the Dexterous Crafter. We often have a bit of fun and banter on the show. Nat has our section where she tries to really foggle us with her pictures of kits, and sometimes Lewis has a little bit of a wibble, but it's all good fun. So come along and join us. We put up the posts during the week to remind you when they are coming up, but it's always on a Saturday night at around about 8 p.m. so that'd be great as well. And we also have the Facebook group for Saturday Night Crash, so have a look for that, join up, that'd be great. And also I have my Facebook group, Totally Scale Models, as well, so come along and join the group as well, that'd be fantastic. So until the next time, take care, stay safe, see you later, bye bye.